You know, a lot of people are like, oh, you can't do this, and you can't do this. No. God knows my heart. He knows my heart. So he knows that, you know, sometimes that's why I need him, and he was there.
I didn't like the album at all. And I was a Kanye West fan. Yeah. But Jesus was whack to me.
Yeah, that's great. That's great. So what were you saying?
I was asking about the whole Jesus, like, what makes you so frustrated?
Yeah, it's not about Jesus. It's about, you know, Michael Jackson was told to play videos on MTV because he was considered to be an urban artist.
Right.
So soon as I started talking about clothing, everybody's going to talk about urban clothing line. Mm-hmm. What I'm trying to say is, like, it's 1,460-something billionaires in the world. I don't know exactly, because somebody might have thought of a new tech idea and their company's valued at what? So 1,470 billionaires. There's only 7 black ones, and we know some of the most famous ones, mm-hmm. so like Oprah, whatever. So, you know, in order to really impact and be in a position of power at this point, you got to be a billionaire. It ain't about being like, you know, a superstar. I don't know nobody that like sells a lot of like records and gets a lot of radio spins that's actually a billionaire either. We get into so much of like, you know, arguing with each other that we're not looking at the main thing. But what I did with Yeezus is I took the, you know, the power into my own hand. I wanted to remove, you know, the hits from it. I wanted to remove the choruses. Of course, Blood on the Leaves and Bound, it's got a chorus. You know, I like resolve the album and let everybody know it's all good at the end of it. But it's not all good, you know? Like I said, I'm from Chicago. People is dying every day, and everybody think we're going to do a benefit concert and help that out. But I need to be put in a position to be able to apply my thoughts, the same thoughts. You know, before I came in the game, rappers is killing each other. Mm-hmm. You ain't even heard about it. Nothing matter to me except for the people and the way I can affect them. I almost lost my life. I lost my mama. I went from, like, you know, Jay-Z being my idol, still is my idol, to him being across the stage on me. So I know that anything is possible. Mm-hmm. Oh, when they hold me down, my BS meter is at an all-time high.
Yeah, but what you accomplished so much. What?
Yeah.
What? Like, what's so bad?
They want to hear him talk, man. No. They want this man to throw them blows, man. That's what they're waiting for. They waiting for Charlamagne.
I'm not trying to throw blows, but this is what I want to know.
Let's go.
Like, to me, it seems like you're such a walking contradiction, because you'll denounce the corporations, but then you'll get on stage and say you need Nike and Adidas to back you. That makes no sense to me.
100%.
But how can you denounce the corporations, say F the corporations, and say you feel like a slave, but then ask the companies to back you?
It ain't that I feel like a slave. We are mentally enslaved. We enslaved to brands. We enslaved to, like, a Ben symbol. We enslaved to chains. A woman is enslaved to the concept of diamonds are a girl's best friend. Like, girls in London don't even wear engagement ring. That's all been programmed into us. When we born artists, we born free, and then we held down by society's perception of us. We just don't want to be embarrassed. And I took the opportunity to look as stupid as possible. I'm saying, when I was in Chicago and watched The Throne, I was going to change my outfit to some normal leather pants and stuff. And they tailored it. One was too tight. Then the next one ripped on me. And I felt like God was like, nah, man, you can't be scared in Chicago because there's a bunch of gangsters and it's where you grew up. I want you to wear that kilt in Chicago. I want you to release that fear. I want you to show as an artist that you could create to the highest level. You know what I'm saying? So
what that got to do with you denouncing corporations?
The same reason why you got to involve me and you got to cut me in. You know what I'm saying? People got fat without me. You cutting me in. Because people were having negotiating while I was negotiating with Nike. They said, okay, cool, Kanye. You've been screaming up and down. We're going to give you a deal for Yeezy, finally. Because they was marginalizing me. Let me only design 2 shoes over a 5-year period. People talking about the Red October. That's the design for 3 years ago. You know how many ideas I got? You know what I'm saying? So they try to marginalize me. And then they say, look, we're going to give you $4 million a year to design this. I said, what about royalties? They said, look, you know, you're not a professional athlete, so you don't get no royalties. I said, look, man, I go to any of these arenas and play one on nobody. I'm a performance athlete, and more than being an athlete, I'm Walt. I'm like Howard Hughes. I'm like David Stern. I'm like Steve Jobs. If anything, that's a compliment to them. I'm like Michelangelo, because I'm the new version of that. And anybody that backs me is going to be the Medici family that backed Michelangelo at this point. You know what I'm saying? So when they told me I couldn't get no royalties, it's like, wait a second, you want me to work for Nike for 2 more years? I can't. When I tell my daughter in 2 years that I've been working trying to make Nike still hot, and I still don't have, you know, the backing to really support and protect her, because she in a position. Yeah, you know what it was? It's because, you know, last night, I think my, what people call a rant, what I call a visionary, a stream of consciousness, it was better. Like right now, this morning is better because my voice is hoarse. Mm-hmm. The problem is when I get too loud, it's just too loud. You know what I'm saying? If you know how people, you know, come into the studio, play their music, they play it so loud for you and they make you think you like a beat. Mm-hmm. And you don't even know if you like it now. You just like blew somebody's ears out and stuff. So when I'm talking, a lot of times it's like I'm blowing people's ears out. My technique is too harsh. I'm beating it up too harsh. And the problem was, you know, with Dame, his truth was more accurate and more closer to what mine was, but his technique was harsh for me as a young kid and stuff. I felt like a little bit more pressure.
Dame was an ass. He was an ass.
And Jay-Z's was a nice guy. Right. And also, I felt like the truth that Dame has in him. We the same. Mm-hmm. Like me and Cam, me and Dame, we the same. But I wanted to learn this technique that Jay got of being actually being likable. Like when I was doing Watch the Throne, one of the main reasons why I did it was to learn, you know, Jay's techniques of how he talked to people. Man, I be talking to people the wrong way sometimes.
Me too.
I be reverse. Now the thing is, if Big Sean come up and rap for me, and I give him some advice, but I don't give him a deal, at that point, I'm sonning him. Mm-hmm. I'm like, take that advice and go run with it. No, we ain't Jewish. We don't got family that got money like that. The rappers became a new family. Dame created a family at Rockefeller and stuff. A family for these young boys from the hood to do a clothing line, to do that, to that. This whole time, he was fighting for Jay. He was up at the label fighting for Jay, and he the one that ended up getting ousted out of it. Right now, I'm in the fashion world fighting for Kim. If we broke up, I would be the one that's looked like as an asshole. I would be the Dame of the situation, right, and she would be the Jay of the situation right there. So it's, man, that's my point to that.
Now, with all your artists, with Big Sean and with Pusha T, with all your artists, yeah. I mean, there's things that I do sometimes that Charlamagne Yee don't like. Are they that open with you if they say, you know what, I didn't like this type of record?
Yeah, you heard when Big Sean was up here and he said that he didn't...
He said it wasn't his favorite album.
Jesus was his least favorite album. You dropped him from good for a little minute.
No, I ain't never dropped him from good, but I'm going to tell you something. Everybody make good music on good music. Drake on good music. Ross on good music. If you make good music, you on good music. Nike's only a $26 billion company. Apple's a $600 billion company. They not the same level. And part of the reason is because they too busy trying to compete, trying to do the smaller ideas. It's only one Steve Jobs, you know what I'm saying? And now it's only one Kanye West, and I'm just like Steve.
Why do you talk so much about money nowadays, man? I used to look at you as like a real revolutionary. You know, real revolutionaries didn't need money to change the world. Malcolm X wasn't rich. Martin Luther King Jr. wasn't rich. Like, I don't understand why everything is so much about money and stuff to you now.
Because you need product. You need to own something to have a voice at this point. Because I'm telling you...
But you already got them. You don't need to own something to have a voice. Yeah, you had a voice. When you got on stage and you said, George Bush don't care about black people, you was using your voice. You don't need money to have a voice.
I could use my voice, but what happened if y'all don't buy no albums? Then that voice, people gonna say, oh, he like Arsenio Hall, and he was turning up too much, and now you fired. But when you got money, can't nobody fire you.
No, you know what makes me buy your albums? The great music you produce. You know what makes me not buy your albums? This new narcissistic, egotistical personality you got. That's what turns me off. It makes me say, oh, I'm not going to the show. I don't want him, man. I don't want to buy records.
Exactly, but I'm thinking that your last name is the God, right?
Absolutely.
So anybody that's a God can recognize a God. Jesus can recognize Jesus. I mean, you know, y'all know what it is.
God's got to keep other gods.
You know, a lot of people are like, oh, you can't do this. No. God knows my heart. He knows my heart. So he knows that, you know, sometimes that's why I need him. And he was there.